Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss a short story called The Eyes Are Not There, written by Ruskin Bond. It was originally known as The Eyes Have It, or it is also known as The Girl on the Train. This story first appeared in the collection Night Train at Deoli, published in 1988. Now let's see what is there in the story. Once, the writer of this story was travelling from Rohana. Meanwhile, at one station, a girl got in the same compartment in which the writer was. Her parent came to say goodbye to her and left with giving instruction to her. Then, the train pulled out the station. As the writer was totally blind, he could not see the girl. He was unable to tell how she looked like. When she talked with her parents, the writer liked her voice. So, he asked her if she was going all the way to Dehra. She gave a little exclamation and told him that she did not know anyone there in the compartment. The writer was wondered and said to himself if he could be able to see her. The girl said that she was getting down at Shaharanpur, as her aunt was meeting her there. She too asked him where he was going. The writer answered, to Dehra, and then next to Mussoorie. The girl was also interested to go to Mussoorie, as she loved the hills there in the month of October. So, she told him that he was very lucky. The writer then told her about the Mussoorie hills in the October month. He said that the hills are covered with the wild dahlias. The sun is delicious and you can enjoy the night in front of a long fire with a little brandy. He said most of tourists went Mussoorie in October as it was the best time to visit. The girl was silent, so the writer thought that she might have understood that he was blind. But next moment she asked why he did not look out of the window. The writer pretended as if he was looking off window by telling her the landscape outside. He ventured that trees seemed to be moving outside. The girl said that it always happens, but whether he saw any animals from the window. The writer replied, "Not too much, hardly any animals can be seen." Then both sat in silence for a while. The writer knew that the girls like flattery, so he made daring and said that she had an interesting face. She pleasantly laughed and said many people told her about her pretty and interesting face. She told him that he was a very gallant young man and asked why he was serious, to which the writer replied nothing. Whereas the writer thanked God for a short journey with a pretty girl. Then he said, the girl in front would forget a short meeting, but it would stay with him for the rest of his life. At the next station, she got up and collected her things. Outside the train, there was the shouting of porters and vendors, and high-pitched female voice, which must be of her aunt, said the writer in his mind. The girl said goodbye to the writer. As she was standing very close to him, the perfume from her hair was attracting him to touch her hair, but she moved away and the smell of perfume only remained in his mind. Then, the next man got into the compartment. The writer asked him about the girl's hairs, whether they were short or long. The man told in a puzzled voice that he did not remember her hair, but he noticed her eyes, which were beautiful, but were of no use. She was completely blind. Therefore, the writer was disappointed to hear that the girl who was traveling with him was also blind and pretended her that he could see everything, but he was also blind. The irony in the story is that the writer comes to know that the girl in front of him was blind just after she had got off the train. Hence, the pathos and irony in the situation adds to the effect of the whole story. and pity and sorrow can be felt by a reader. So, that's it for this video. See you next time. If you like my video and wish to support me, then please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.